Today, we will learn to create a simple relational database in Microsoft Access. In this exercise, we will learn to create a table using table design. We will create forms and input data using forms. We will learn to import data from MS Excel into an existing table. We will create tables automatically from Microsoft Excel data while importing data as well. We will learn to create queries from relational databases. And finally, we will learn how to create reports in Microsoft Access. We have products, salesperson, order type, and orders data in Microsoft Excel, which we want to convert into Microsoft Access relational database. To create a table, open Microsoft Access and click on the Table Design button in Create tab. In the Table Design, enter the names of fields and their data type. The first column is ID, which is a number. The second column is product title, which is a short text. The third column is price per unit, which is currency. Save the table as products. Set the ID column as primary key. Primary key column has unique values, which are used in relationships. You can enter data directly into a table in Microsoft Access. You can also create forms to enter data into Microsoft Access tables. While the table is selected, go to the Create tab and click on the Form button. This will create a form where you can enter data. Save the form into the database. There are navigation buttons at the bottom of the form. When the next button is clicked, a blank row is created, where you can enter fresh data. Let's enter the next record into the product table using the form. Pressing Tab button after entering the last field will save the record. Let's go to the table to check if the data is entered or not. As you can see, you can enter data directly into a table, or you can enter data through forms. But both of these methods are highly inefficient. If you have data already available in a computer, for example, in an MS Excel file, you can directly import that data into Microsoft Access table. Delete the data from the products table. Now, let's import data from Microsoft Excel into Microsoft Access table using Import Data Wizard. If the file name field, enter the name of Excel file from which you want to import the data. Since we have already created the table, we will append a copy of the records to the table. Next, we will select the table we want to import. Check the option, first row contains column headings. Press Finish to import data into Microsoft Access. We created the product table manually from product design. However, Microsoft Access can automatically create tables from external data sources, such as Microsoft Excel. To import a data from Microsoft Excel and automatically create a table, open the Get External Data window. Select the file you want to import. Now, select Import Data into a new table instead of Append a Copy option, and press OK. Now, select the table you want to import. Select the first row contains column headings checkbox. Review the data types, selected by Microsoft Access automatically, and make changes if necessary. Select the ID field as primary key. Press Finish to create a new table, and import data from Microsoft Excel. Follow the same process, to create the other tables, and import their data into Microsoft Access. Now, we have all the four tables, and their data, in our Microsoft Access database. Now, we will create relationships between these tables, using their primary keys. In the database tools, click on the Relationships button. Add all the tables, into the relationship window. Link the primary key of each table, to their relevant field, in the Orders table. Now your Microsoft Access database is a relational database. To create a query using this relational database, go to the Create tab and select Query Design. Add all the tables to the Query Design window. Select ID and date from the Orders table. Instead of product field in orders, select the product title from the products table. Instead of salesperson from orders table, select the first name and the last name from the salesperson's table. Combine the first name and the last name using an expression to form a single name field. Change the name of the expression to name. Select the type from order type instead of order type from orders. Select the weight from the orders table. Select the price per unit from the products table. Use an expression to calculate the total price by multiplying weight to the price per unit. Save the query into the Microsoft Access database. Save it as sales query. Let's see the result of our query. Now we have the entire information from all tables in a single table in a meaningful form. In our final exercise, we will create a report based on this sales query. While the query is selected, go to the Create tab, and click on the Report wizard. Select the product title, weight, price per unit, and price fields from the sales query. Group the report by product title. In the next window, click on the Summary options. Select Average for weight, and sum for price per unit, and price fields. Select the summary only option as well. Leave the sorting options, and press Finish to display the report. The report has been created. You can go to the design view, and make changes to the report as you like. We will make some changes, to make the report more compact, and visually appealing. You can drag fields around, and resize them as you like. You can change the default titles, as per your requirement. Once you're done, you can switch to the report view, to view the report. The headings are not in their proper place. Let's go to the design view, and place the headings correctly. The sales report, by product title is now complete. Other reports can also be created in the same manner. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.